Okay, gentlemen, if you'll bear with me, we have a few minutes left till lunch. I'd like to run over the points of the jacket as we've covered them. Derek, would you come up and we'll try this second jacket here? If you watch him carefully, gentlemen, as he puts it on, you'll notice that there are three buttons to be used. Make sure they're all fastened, that's what they're there for. And having fastened all three, if you turn around, Derek, now, remember, take a good breath and pull the straps to a comfortable fit. That's fine. And if you turn around again to face the class, remember always to check that none of the inflatable part of the jacket is caught up in your harnesses, the parachute harness. That is how it should look, and we're ready to inflate now, Derek. And now, gentlemen, if we can just show the adjustment cords finally. Derek, would you pull this one? They adjust the lobes to give a better flotation angle in the water. You would only use these, that's fine, you would only use these if there's no chance of you boarding the dinghy within a few moments of ditching. Would you like to pull the other one now? You've seen how the difference is. Once they are both pulled down against the body, entry into the dinghy is made much more difficult. You see how they are held down to the harness at the bottom there, and the center of support is much lower down the body.
Bill overdoes this survival business just a bit.
Well, he does ramble on.
Is that Bill Rogers you're talking about?
Yes, it is. Yeah.
Well, of course, he's got good cause to be keen, you know.
Why is that?
Well, when Bill was still a co-pilot, they had to ditch. The captain was injured and Bill had to take command.
What happened?
Well, give me a splash of the old soda, huh?
Coming up.
Well, I think, I'm not quite sure whether it's safe. Coming on.
Thank you.
This is a bloody fine state of affairs. I never thought it could happen to me. Let's see, I suppose the drillers who tend to be injured first.
Tell them, Johnny, can you see to the captain? He looks unconscious.
Okay.
I'll put on a dressing, that's all I can do. Let's hope it's only a slight concussion.
Well, there's no sign of any of the other ruts from the aircraft.
There are no others. The ditching rut, they're off. This is the position as I see it. We shall have to be thankful we got away with it so well. Apart from the captain. Now make the most of it. I don't think we should be here long.
Well, what do we do now?
Tell you the truth, I'm a bit rusty on the procedure. Is anything in the routine?
I think I can help.
There. I always knew that would come in handy.
Blimey, you've got it. Got up like a...
Yes, I know. Roll call. Well, we're all here. Cut adrift from aircraft. We've done that. Rendezvous with life rafts. That's not applicable. Ah, here we are. Stream drogue and close the curtains.
Baker, will you throw the drogue out? And Davis, get this curtain fastened up. The life raft for damage. It appears to be okay. At first aid, we've done. We've got to get the water out, Meg, and inflate the floor.
Davies, can you carry on with a sponge? And Mav, will you inflate the floor?
Baker.
Leave him alone. Let him rest.
Hey, quiet. I can hear air escaping.
Steady on now. Let's get organized.
It's here. This is it. It's the relief valve. No, leave it. It's only excess pressure escaping. That shows there's no major damage to the raft.
Let's get our boots off and wring out our socks. We'll feel warm if we do. Much warmer now. Come on, now, let's get this place tidied up. It's in a hell of a mess. Simmons, get the emergency flap open and Baker, sort this quite out, will you? Mav, will you see to the paddles?